Good morning and welcome to this week's edition of the Deliverance Time broadcast, sponsored by the members and friends of Eccles Assembly of God. Eccles Assembly is located at lots 57 to 59 Public Road, Eccles, on the east bank of the Marara. I'm your radio pastor, Michael Pereira, encouraging you to stay tuned and be blessed by some inspiring music and a timely message from the Word of God.
Spirit, thou art welcome in this place.
You have been faithful. We do not want to take your blessings for granted, so we come before you with grateful hearts and we say thanks. Thanks for the favor you have shown. Now we ask you to use this broadcast to challenge and transform lives. Let the songs and your preached word minister to all our listeners. Thank you for saving the lost and healing the sick. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Welcome again to this week's edition of the Deliverance Time broadcast, sponsored by the members and friends of Eccles Assembly of God. You'll find us at Lots 57 to 59 Public Road, Eccles, on the east bank of Demerara. We invite you to join us for our in-person service this morning and every Sunday morning beginning at 9:30. For those who may not be able to attend the in-person service, there will be live streaming of the fellowship service starting at 9:30. Just connect with us on our Facebook page. That's the Eccles Assembly of God Facebook page. We invite you also to join us every Thursday at 7 for our midweek Bible study. Please do remember to write and let us know of the specific blessings you have been receiving through this Deliverance Time broadcast. And, of course, our online ministry. Our mailing address is Deliverance Time, care of Eccles, Assembly of God, 57-59 Public Road, Eccles, on the east bank of Demerara. You may also contact us on telephone numbers 233-2124 or 233-2982 during regular working hours from Monday to Friday. And may I let you know as well that you can send your letters of testimony to our email address. That's Eccles AG, one word, all lowercase, EcclesAG@gmail.com. Stay tuned for the ministry of the Word of God.
I'm reading this morning from the book of Acts, chapter 27. We'll begin at verse 21. After the men had gone a long time without food, Paul stood up before them and said, "Men, you should have taken my advice not to sail from Crete. Then you would have spared yourselves this damage and loss. But now I urge you to keep up your courage, because not one of you will be lost. Only the ship will be destroyed. Last night, an angel of the God whose I am and whom I serve stood beside me and said, 'Do not be afraid, Paul. You must stand trial before Caesar. And God has graciously given you the lives of all who sail with you. So keep up your courage, men, for I have faith in God that it will happen just as he told me. Nevertheless, we must run aground on some island.'" God speaks to us directly and indirectly. When God speaks to us directly, it is quite often through an inward witness, a clear, distinct voice from deep within our innermost being. The voice may not be audible, but you know as a child of God, in tune with him, that God is speaking to you. However, there are times when God chooses to speak to us indirectly. He does so as we read the scriptures which contain his will, plan, and purpose for our lives. God speaks to us indirectly through the religious programs we watch on TV or those we listen to on the radio. Right now, God is speaking to you, madam, through this Deliverance Time broadcast. God also speaks to us through the circumstances of life, the various experiences we go through. Paul's shipwreck as he was on his way to Rome is a good example of how God speaks to us through circumstances, even the storms of life. Now, it is good to hear God's voice at any time, but it is especially good to hear him speak to us in the midst of the storms of life. Lady, in this the hour of your need, God is speaking to you. Sir, As you face those difficulties, those adversities, God is speaking. Now let us quickly examine some of the lessons we can learn from Paul's experience of that storm as he was on his way to Rome. One of the first lessons we can learn from this episode is that storms come suddenly, sometimes seemingly without reason. In our scripture reading, Luke, who it is believed, wrote the book of Acts, tells us that a gentle south wind began to blow. All was calm and peaceful, but alas, it was the calm before the storm. Verse 14 tells us that before long, a wind of hurricane force swept down upon them. The ship in which Paul was traveling was caught by the storm. So often in life, the fierce south wind blows upon us, and we hope to obtain our purpose in life. Then suddenly, a tremendous storm blows into our lives, leaving a trail of broken dreams, shattered hopes, and suffering that sometimes affect the whole family. Quite often, these storms change the whole direction of our lives. At such times, it is well to remember that God is still in control and that his voice may be heard even in the midst of life's storms. Now, where do storms originate? In the Old Testament, we read about a man by the name of Job. He suffered immensely, and according to the biblical account, his storms came from Satan. Now, it was Jesus who said that the enemy, our enemy, the enemy of all mankind, comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Storms are sometimes part of Satan's arsenal. Satan uses various storms to achieve his purposes. As individuals, more so as a nation in turmoil, we need to look beyond all the negative trends and developments going on around us and see the devil at work seeking to steal, kill, and destroy. Remember, friend, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in heavenly places. So some of the storms we face come directly from the enemy, Satan. But let me hasten to remind you that no storm can come into the life of a child of God except God permits it. But while storms are sometimes engineered by the devil, at other times they are of our own making, the result of bad choices. The captain of the ship in which Paul was a passenger made a wrong choice. We read about that in Acts chapter 27. Friend, let me tell you this. God has presented before us in his word the consequences of the course we take. But so often, we choose to continue walking in our own ways, and suddenly we find ourselves in the teeth of a storm. I need to say to someone listening to this broadcast this morning, you are bent on having your own way in that situation. You know that your actions are inconsistent with God's plan and purpose for your life. Remember, my friend, there is a way which seemeth right unto a man, but the ends thereof are the ways of death. If you sow to the flesh, you shall of the flesh reap corruption. If you sow to the wind, you will reap the whirlwind. I want to urge you this morning, stop, look, and listen, young man. Heed the voice of God and abort that storm that is in the making in your life because of your rebellion. Then there are storms that come upon us as a consequence of the actions of others. Circumstances over which we have no control break upon us and we feel trapped. Yes, our actions, our choices, our decisions often affect not just ourselves, but others. I challenge all my listeners today, Let God help you to make the right choices. Live responsibly so that our society can be a better place in which to live. Neighbor, storms come to all of us. If you haven't yet experienced a storm, I guarantee that someday you will stand face to face with adversity. When that time comes, just remember, God speaks even in the midst of storms. One of the very vital lessons we can learn from Paul's experience is that storms do not mean that we are not in the will of God. Let us use Paul's experience as an example. What was Paul, this great man of God, doing in a storm? His ministry was seemingly curtailed. He was on his way to imprisonment in Rome. He is now about to be shipwrecked. Did God forget Paul? 1,000 times no, my friend. God was simply working out his purpose for Paul and for the kingdom. This is clearly seen in the fact that much of the New Testament was born out of Paul's prison experiences. My friend, God is always able to make all things work together for our good if only we would listen to his voice and allow his leading, follow his leading, even though all around us the storm might be raging. I notice in our scripture reading that Paul endeavored to avoid the storm. And hear me, my friends, some storms cannot be avoided. Paul warned the men not to set sail, but they failed to heed him, and the circumstances were out of his control. Before long, a storm came in all its fury, and all efforts to save the vessel failed. Their own wisdom told them to abandon ship. However, God's instruction was that all who stayed with the ship would be saved. It takes courage to obey God's message and stay the course when things seem to be going from bad to worse. Storms challenge our resolve to trust and obey. I notice also that sometimes storms are confusing. Many times they are this way. We don't know which way to turn or how to resolve our conflicts, how to solve our crises. The storm descends like a dark cloud, separating us from everyone and everything. Hope vanishes and peace flees. We wonder, does God know I'm here? Does he care about me? On the Sea of Galilee, Jesus spoke peace, and the storm was over instantly. For Paul, it would be a different deliverance. God dispatched an angel to stand before Paul in the midst of the storm and say, "Do not be afraid, Paul. God has graciously given you the lives of all who sail with you." Paul heard the voice of God in the midst of the storm. Oh yes, the ship was lost, but every soul was saved. If God does not take you out of the storm, he will take you through, my dear brother. God has come to us. Thank God. He sent Jesus Christ, his only son, who is touched with the feeling of our infirmities. We can hear God say, "Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteousness." Jesus is in complete control of our lives, and he loves us infinitely and unconditionally. He stands by us at all times and through all circumstances. It is not God's will that we be wrecked in life storms. Jesus Christ reaches out to rescue you, sir. Trust him. There is hope. Jesus says, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." Shall we pray?
We thank you for every listener bowed in your presence at this time. We lift up those who are discouraged and depressed, those who are in the furnace of affliction, O God,
by your Spirit and through the Word, cause them to be strengthened. Father, we know that your grace is sufficient for us. So we just lay our troubles at your feet today. We thank you for touching the sick and the afflicted, the needy and the distressed. We release your anointing to bring deliverance to the captives now. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Friends, it was a joy having you on the broadcast this morning. And we look forward to having you join us next week at the same time for another edition of the Deliverance Time broadcast. Until then, God richly bless you.